So let's talk about Euler angle formulations here for just a moment. So you're familiar with the Euler angles that we're going to be using, and if you're not, I'll put a link to another video that will explain that. We basically use Euler angles phi, theta, and psi. Phi is a bank angle. Theta is what we call an elevation angle. And psi is azimuth angle, okay? And the way that we get the orientation of the aircraft actually matters what order you apply these angles. So from the aircraft line, so you start off with the aircraft aligned with the Earth fixed X coordinate system. So XF, and that's pointed towards the north. And then Y sub F, that's the Y coordinate system pointed to the east. And then Z is into the is pointed down, and that's Z sub F is towards the center of the Earth. So first we rotate the aircraft by the azimuth angle, psi, and so we'd rotate it about this Z axis here. So that then the nose of the aircraft is pointed, whatever direction relative to north here by that azimuth angle. And then we rotate it up and incline it to an elevation angle, theta. And then finally, we apply a bank angle about the aircraft x-axis, okay? And that gives us our bank angle. So, and that gives us an orientation. And again, you can go back and review that in the previous video. I go into a lot more detail there. So, if this didn't make sense, please go review that. Well, it turns out that this is just one of 12 different ways you can apply the Euler angle formulations. What we've done here is applied a rotation about the Z axis, then a rotation about the Y axis of the aircraft, and finally, a rotation about the X axis, okay? And each time we're moving the coordinates of that aircraft. So for example, the very first rotation when we take it from due north and rotate it around to the azimuth angle, whatever azimuth angle is, then the next, so that was a rotation about the Z axis, but then we rotate about the Y axis where we the Y axis of the aircraft, right? So that's an elevation angle. We rotate it up. And then finally, a bank angle about the x-axis. So anyway, we've applied these in the opposite order here, z, y, x, okay? And that's only one of 12 different ways you can do this. It turns out that the Euler angles can be used in any order here. And in fact, because your coordinates are changing, as you rotate here, you can actually do what are called symmetric rotations instead of asymmetric. So let's first talk about the asymmetric coordinates. So this is one of the asymmetric coordinates transformations that we are going to use, and that's the ZYX. But actually, we could have applied that. So let's list these out here. So we can have asymmetric rotations. We could have put that. We could have used X to y to z, right? We could have also done y x z, z x y, x z y z x, or z y x, okay? So the one that we're using is this coordinate here, and this is the order that these transformations get applied. And this is what is usually used in the aeronautics community. Okay, so that's the traditional way. Now, you can also, so those are six different asymmetric combinations here where we use all X, Y, and Z. You can also use a set of symmetric rotations. And this is where you actually apply a rotation first about one axis, let's say X, and then you go and rotate about the Y axis, and then you go back and rotate again about the X axis because your original axis that you started from is different now. So So for example, if we were to come back to this drawing here, so first maybe you rotate about Z, and then you rotate about Y, and now if you can imagine that the nose of your aircraft is pointed up, the Z axis of the aircraft is no longer aligned with this Earth fixed Z axis. And so you can do a rotation about the Z axis of the aircraft. So we would have done Z, Y, and then come back to Z. We can do a rotation about the Z axis again because it's actually a different axis. And so so you can still actually represent any orientation of the aircraft by applying the first and the last rotation about the same coordinate system onboard the aircraft, which is a different coordinate system than the Earth fixed coordinate system. So anyway, let's just list those. So you could do an X to Y, back to X. You can do a Y, X, Y, or a Z, X, Z. You can do X, Z, X, Y, Z, Y, or a Z, Y, Z. Okay, so those are the six options for symmetric rotations. And this coordinate system here, or this rotation, is what's usually used in orbital mechanics. Okay, so the important thing to know here is that there's a lot of different ways to do this, and we've gravitated toward these conventions in aeronautics and orbital mechanics. And so this is what's used, but you could, you know, in theory, use any of these 12 different ways to apply Euler angles, and it would still work out. Now, we've already seen that that this coordinate system transformation here results in gimbal lock. And it turns out that every single one of these transformations, no matter if they're asymmetric or symmetric, every single one of them has gimbal lock at some point in the orientation, meaning that you get a divide by zero in your transformation. And so so because of that, it turns out that there's no perfect Euler angle formulation here that can get rid of gimbal lock. Every single one of them will have it. So one way to get around gimbal lock is to actually track two different orientations at the same time. So maybe we want to track these two at the same time, but you choose two different orientations that have gimbal lock at a different location. And when you get close to an orientation where you know one of your transformations is going to have gimbal lock, then you switch over, you know, you switch over and use a different transformation while you pass through gimbal lock, and then you switch back over to your other orientation once you're past there. So anyway, this is one way to get around the gimbal lock issue. But let's just make a note here that every transformation, and particularly every Euler angle transformation or formulation, has gimbal lock at some point. Okay, at some point in the orientation. So you can track two at the same time to get around this, but that's inefficient from a computational standpoint. And so we're going to talk about other methods that are more efficient rather than tracking two different Euler angle formulations.